Hi, my name is Carrie Hope Fletcher and I'm playing Parson Nathaniel's wife, Beth. Well, as I said, I'm playing Parson Nathaniel's wife, Beth, with the lovely Jason Donovan, who's over there doing interviews. Yes, I'm playing his wife, and the part is it's a fabulous part to play, and there's been some amazing women who've played it before me. But yeah, Parson Nathaniel has gone a little bit possessed, and he thinks that the Martians are the devil's been sent to Earth to try and take over the world, and she's sort of the voice of reason, and she needs to kind of tell him that's not the case, and you need to, you know, buck your ideas up, sort of thing. So yeah, she's sort of the voice of hope and reason behind that particular song. As you probably know, it's based on the book by H.G. Wells, so it's, you know, it was written sort of in the 1800s. But the story is, I feel it's still relevant today because it's, you know, that humans are the problem kind of thing. It's this idea that we're kind of destroying this earth, which, you know, is still a relevant story, and people are still, you know, interested in that. And it's also, you know, it's such a spectacular thing to look at with all the aliens and the illusions and the pyros. It's like such an amazing thing to watch, and the music is incredible. Jeff, I've said for ages that Jeff is a complete genius, and his songs are just so wonderful to listen to, and the music is so iconic. And so when you see it all come together on stage with like an amazing cast, the guys in the show are incredible. They're such fun to work with as well. So, you know, with this amazing cast, amazing music, incredible sets, it's just, you know, why wouldn't anyone want to see it? I mean, I've watched these guys on TV for most of my life. So to suddenly be working with them, it's incredible. And they're all so lovely. Like that, it's the worst thing is when you know, you've idolized someone for so long, or you've watched someone on TV for so long, and then you meet them and they're not that nice. These guys are genuinely the nicest, funniest people to work with, and we're in rehearsals, and already I've laughed harder than I've laughed in a very, very long time. So going on tour with these guys is going to be absolutely incredible.
I mean, you've been a part of some very special productions. You've obviously taken time out of Les Mis to come and do this. How does this compare to other shows that you've been involved with? What sets it apart, do you think?
It's so much bigger. Everything is on a much bigger scale. Like, I've never worked on a stage this big. I've never worked with sets this big. Like, that Martian fighting machine, that alien is huge. I think it weighs something like 3 tons. And, you know, I'm in Les Mis, I'm performing to, like, 1,000 people a night, which in itself is... that's a massive audience. But arenas, it's going to be like 10,000 people a night, which is something I've never done before. So, you know, it's going to be pretty spectacular, and something I'm not going to forget for ever. I don't think I can quite describe it. I know that sounds really cliche, like, oh, I have no words, but it's genuinely... it's insane. Like, and the feedback from the audience at the end of a performance, when you finally sort of come out of character and you can see them all, you know, clapping and applauding and cheering and whooping, it's such a buzz, it's such a thrill. And it I think the shakes that I get from that adrenaline rush after a show is 10 times worse than before I go on and I'm stood there going, oh my God, I'm absolutely bricking it. But it's incredible, it's absolutely amazing, indescribable. I just panic and panic and panic until someone goes, you've got to go on! That is literally, I'm the worst with coping with nerves. Like, I'm really, really awful, and I will be sat backstage just quiet going right until someone tells me I've got to come onto stage. I'm awful with nerves, but it's just one of those things where you've just got to do it, otherwise you will never do it. And once you've come off stage, you know, you want to do it again because you want to do it without worrying this time. I think the further along the tour I go, the better it will be. But no, I've always been the worst for nerves, and I have no tips for coping with nerves to anyone watching this. No tips.
What was it that initially made you want to be a performer and particularly on stage?
I've never really known anything else. It's kind of always been what I've loved ever since I was, you know, toddling along, ever since I could, you know, first sing and dance. It's kind of been the only thing I'm good at. Genuinely, anything else I'm pretty rubbish at. Performing is kind of the one thing that sort of came naturally, and so there was never really any question, apart from when I wanted to be an archaeologist because I liked Indiana Jones. You know. So yeah, it's just been what I've loved since I was tiny, and there's never really been any question that I was going to do anything else.
I'm curious, when you were younger watching theatre, are there any particular performers or productions that really inspired you and made you think, that's exactly what I want to be doing?
Les Mis was always the big one for me. Lea Salonga is, you know, I've been watching her on the Hamish the Producer VHS that I've had since I was tiny. Eponine was that role that, you know, it was sort of the holy grail to me to play that part. So, you know, playing it before this and then after, it's such an honour. But I used to listen to War of the Worlds in the car with my parents, because my parents are massive fans of War of the Worlds. So I've grown up listening to this on car journeys and being absolutely scared senseless by the aliens. To be a part of this now is another sort of childhood dream come true. It's amazing, and I'm so lucky and so grateful to, you know, be a part of things that have come from my childhood that I've, you know, grown up with. It's a very bizarre life I lead. It is everything I imagined it would be and more, but you never quite realise just how relentless it is, because it never stops. It's 8 shows a week in the West End. You get Sundays off, of course, you know, it's kind of like the thing everyone's sort of scrabbling for by the end of the week, that just one sacred day off. It's so wonderful, and it really is everything you'd hoped it would be, but there are just a lot of sacrifices that come with it. Like, seeing friends during the day, usually it's sort of like, guys, I am so tired and I just need to sleep it off today. It's kind of that thing where you're constantly tired. You kind of get to a level where you're just a constant tired, a consistent amount of tired all the time. But of course it's worth it, because every night you get to live out a fantasy, you know, it's incredible. But it is a lot of hard work, and you need to be prepared for that. At Les Mis, stage door is usually full every night, and it's such an overwhelming feeling walking out after, you know, still buzzing from the show. And I've had people come up to me crying before, and I never quite know how to handle it, because I used to be that person that used to stand at stage door and wait for the actors to come out and get really excited and ask for autographs and stuff. To suddenly be on the other side of that, it's very bizarre. And I can't, you know, I still feel like the 14-year-old who stood in front of a bathroom mirror and, you know, practiced on my own. That's I still feel like that person. And of course, you know, a lot has changed in the sense that I'm now getting to sing it on the stage of the Queen's Theatre to an audience every night, but I'm still that 14-year-old girl. So to meet other 14-year-olds coming up to me and, you know, me sort of being their Lea Salonga, you know, the people that I used to look up to, it's such a bizarre experience. But it, you know, I feel so honoured and so grateful. And something like this, you know, I've had people tweeting me saying, we're coming to Birmingham, we're coming to the O2, and it's so indescribable. I don't know how to explain it. It's such a strange thing that I'm still kind of trying to wrap my head around and still trying to cope with and find the ins and outs of it. And it's very, very bizarre, but it's so overwhelmingly brilliant. And I can't wait to, you know, there's going to be familiar faces in the audience, which is going to be great. And it's going to be so nice to see them all, because there's people who often are at stage door for Les Mis coming to see this. And so, you know, it's going to be wonderful to see people around. I've never been on a tour before, because, you know, Les Mis is in Shaftesbury Avenue, Queen's Theatre, every day of the week, every year, you know, it's always there. So this is the first time I get to travel around with the show, and it's so exciting being able to go, now we're going to go to Birmingham and show Birmingham what this show's like, and then we're going to go to Leeds and show Leeds what it's like. And it's, you know, it's really exciting to have, you know, it's an entirely new audience every night. Do you know what, I've never even thought about it that way before. It is going to be incredible getting to travel around with the show and sort of show, it sort of feels like we're showing off. It sort of feels like we're just running around the country going, look how great this show is. It's kind of what it feels like. Everything about the show is spectacular. There's nothing in the show that lets it down in any way possible. The music is incredible. The guys I'm in the show with are indescribable. Their voices are just amazing. And the stage presence that they all have is, you can't not watch it. And the illusions and special effect are unlike anything I've ever seen before. I'm so excited to be part of one of the special illusions. It's all very exciting, and it's just unmissable. You can't miss this. You just can't. It's so good. It's going to be spectacular. Spectacular is the word for it. It's going to be amazing.